Good morning. I thank to VC sir, COE, Professor Mahavir Singh, and organizing committee, Dr. Arvind Sharma, head of the department, Dr. Nidesh Singh, Dr. Mohammad Israel, Dr. Ekta Gupta, Mr. Navneet Singh, K.R. Valma Subharti College of Science, Subharti University, for organizing webinar on advanced material in nanotechnology, and my special thanks to Dr. Ekta for inviting me for this and providing a platform to share my knowledge with the student. I am specifically focusing this lecture for those students who are doing research or want to be a researcher in this field. This lecture is covered into three main topics or areas. First is what is advanced material, introduction of nanotechnology, and examples of advanced material in nanotechnology. So hearing the word of advanced material, question arises in our mind, what are advanced material or are they safe? To start with this, we need to go back to a very beginning. Our humans are great to taking lumps of the stuff and making them useful. Our ancestors, for instance, were very pretty good at using these materials like stone, clays, bronze, iron, copper, to make them tools and other useful objects. This ability to design and engineer a product from very basic material around us has what enabled human civilization. We have been incredibly successful in changing our lives by adding the values to the material. We mine, grow, otherwise collected. But until recently, how we made the use of these materials was limited. But what we could see with our eye, what we could touch with our hand. Then we discovered the atom. Everything changed over a period of few decades at the beginning of 20th century. Scientists and engineers went from the beginning being limited by what they could see in touch or being to able play with the basic building blocks of all materials. It was the pivotal point in human development, and we are only just beginning to realize the full significance. But what this means for advanced material, we will look at how the atomic revolution opened the door of new age in material engineering, and how this paved the way of modern era of advanced designer material at this point. We have looked at how our ability to design and engineer the material around us has brought us to where we are today. But we also saw the millennia people were limited and how they made the use of these material, what they could see with their eye or what they could touch with their hand. All of this changed when the discovery of atom and how to play with them at the beginning of 20th century. Scientists confirmed that everything around us is made of atom. Something we take for granted now, it wasn't so obvious 100 years ago. Research has quickly developed instruments that allow them to see how these atoms come together to create materials. These instruments enabled them to start working out how what a material does depend not only on atom is made or material is made, but how the atoms are arranged together. Then they discovered how to create new materials by putting atoms together in different way, and the world changed. Of course, this did not happen over a night. The first breakthrough came about in early 90s when the techniques such as XRD, atomic force microscope, TEM, transmission electron microscope, and SAM, scanning electron microscopes, was discovered, that allow the scientist to see for the first time how atoms form a material, and to understand how the material behave at a macroscopic scale depend on the atoms arranged at microscopic scale. It wasn't just stuff like metals or other inorganic materials that they were exploring. Scientists to use same techniques to learn how organic materials were constructed. how they function all the way down to the DNA and the properties that are at the core of the all living things. Once the scientist and engineer had discovered the atomic rule of material construction, they set about the design new materials using new developed synthesis and characterization technique. They start to make designer chemicals and they quickly move to a more complex materials that were stronger, lighter, that conduct electricity and heat barrier, matter that transmit or block the light and other form of radiation more effectively, and did other things that had previously been out of reach. They achieved this by manipulating the structure of these material at the incredibly fine scale. And but the researchers were still limited to finest with their good engineer materials at a finest level. They knew that if only they could play around with atoms themselves, they could do incredible things. They did not have the tools and the skill to do this. Now they do. And this is what opened the door of new era of advanced materials. We'll look how our ability to design the engineer material from atoms has launched a new era of advanced material in nanotechnology. Nanotechnology is not a new technology. Since the nanotechnology was introduced by Nobel laureate Richard P. Feynman during his famous lecture 1959, there was a plenty of room at the bottom, and there have been many revolutionary development in physics, chemistry, biology, and have demonstrated Feynman's idea of manipulating matter at extremely small scale and the level of molecules and atoms at that is nanoscale. Nanotechnology divided into two approaches. First is top-down approach and second is bottom-up approach. Here is a figure for this. In top-down approach, in which larger structures are reduced in size to nanoscale while maintaining their original property without atomic level control, or deconstructed from a larger structure into a smaller components part, yeah, composite parts. In bottom-up approach, also called molecular nanotechnology, or you can say molecular manufacturing, in which materials are engineered from atoms or molecular components through a process of assembly or self-assembly. There are few techniques for both approaches. In top-down approaches, chemical etching, laser ablation, myelin process, sputtering, thermal decomposition, lithography. In bottom-up approach, Kirin nanotechnology and chemical vapor decomposition, sol gel method, laser pyrolysis, prep methods, and condensation aerosol process. While most contemporary technology relies on top-down approach, molecular nanotechnology holds great promise for breakthrough in materials and manufacturing, electronics, medicine, healthcare, energy biotechnology, information technology, and national security. Nanomaterials deal with the size of 100 nanometer or smaller, at least one dimensional. The material property of nanostructure are different from the bulk due to high surface area over a volume ratio and possible appearance of quantum effect at the nanoscale. Nanomaterials have multifarious property, and therefore, according to their property, they are also used in differently in various applications. So according to their uses and application, material is selected. According to material, synthesis process is selected. What factor influence the property of nanoscale materials? High surface area, shapes, orientation are main factors. And the availability of surface electrons, orientation for reaction in high surface area mainly differentiate the nanomaterials behavior, same as the case in absorption, transmission of light, which varies from size to size and shape to shape. One of the most challenging of our time is to find alternate of energy source which has environmentally friendly, which is depending on the use of nanomaterials. in the different applications such as solar cells, paint, or other application in the field of green chemistry, green electricity. So material for future, here is a basic idea. We keep all the time of human welfare. Because of human welfare, we need to develop the materials by considering a more cleaner energy and more cleaner environment. So that the material, what we produce, they should be recyclable as well as for taking into consideration for a national security and next generation workforce. We have discovered how the arrangement of atoms and material influence how those material behave. And we have started to use this understanding to design and create new materials that have never before existed. This hardly combination of new technology, new tools and technique for manipulating materials in is enabling scientists and engineers to create products that were unimaginably just a few years ago. We still learning how to use these tools. Our knowledge is rather patchy in some area, but already researchers are using them to create incredibly array of materials that pushes the bound of possible material. For instance, that are lighter, stronger, tougher than even before. Material that generates bands and absorb the light in unusual way. The material that converts sunlight and heat and moment of electricity, another form of energy materials. Materials that help to get drugs to where they need to be in body parts or prevent diseases. Materials that create high performance replacement body parts. Materials that keep food fresh and food healthier. Materials that help chemical reaction go faster. To work differently, materials that are enable faster, more powerful computers. Computers that are just plain different, like a quantum computer, for instance. We have only just started to our understanding increases. It is a smart question. Advanced material are designed to behave differently from conventional material, and it is reasonable to assume that different behavior could lead to different risk. It is relatively small step. Here's few examples for advanced material in nanotechnology. It is relatively small step to including safety parameter in designing the process, as long as we know what makes something harmful or how to reduce it. This safety by design approach is already being used in area like green nanotechnology. Innovative approach to developing high performance material that pose minimal risk to people and environment. One example of safety by design and green nanotechnology is the use of advanced titanium dioxide nanoparticle in sunscreen. Many sunscreen use the organic chemical to protect the skin against the sun ultraviolet rays. But to work, these chemicals have to be absorbed into a skin over the time of UV radiation, break them down and make them ineffective. This is why sunscreen need to be reapplied every hour. Inorganic sunscreen, on the other hand, work differently. Particles of insoluble substance like titanium dioxide are applied to the surface of skin where they reflect the UV light. But they also reflect the visible light, look kind of messy. However, making these particles smaller, around 20 nanometer in diameter, hit a sweat spot where they reflect harmful UV light but transmit the visible light. In other words, you have a highly effective yet invisible sunscreen. Apart from one small problem, nano-sized titanium dioxide particle are photoactive mix with water and ultraviolet light. They produce free radicals, highly reactive chemicals that you really don't want to expose. This isn't good news for skin, but it is also not a good news for the product as well. Free radicals also kill long-term performance of product. To overcome this problem, one company engineer examined the sunscreen nanoparticles to be saved by design by adding small amount of metal manganese. This result was highly effective UV protection without protection of harmful free radicals. We learned more about how to make materials safe as well as use of the safety by design is likely become an increasingly important way to ensuring product are acceptable, safe and commercially viable. Here I can show you an example of a smart material, shape memory alloy. This is a small video. Let us do an experiment which is showing in this video. In this video, there is a paper clip which is capped into an ice water solution. You can see the temperature of ice water solution is close to 0 degree centigrade. Therefore, the temperature of this paper clip is also a 0 degree centigrade. Now, let us try to deform this paper clip slowly. Now keep this paper clip into a normal water. The temperature of normal water you can see is 28 degree centigrade. So let us take us this paper clip once again and warm a little bit. It get back to the original phase as each one. This is really, really a smart material. Actually, it was nickel or nickel titanium alloy. So among advanced material, the structure material are also being developed by day. Now, I am showing an example for students. This is very inspiring example. You can start designing material at nano scale, tailing the properties, and you can play with the properties that helps the breaking paradigm which people had in their mind quite some time. For example, when you talk about crystal structure, people always believe that material can divide it into crystal and amorphous. This was considered until 1982. Then scientist Dan Shedman looked up to a particular alloy named aluminium manganese alloy. His interest was to develop a lightweight and a strong alloy. He observed pentagon and five-fold symmetry in diffraction pattern. That time, people believed that five-fold symmetry is impossible in material because five-fold symmetry does not go together with translational symmetry. And people always believe that crystal means you should have translational symmetry. And then people start knowing that possible because such microscope was available. Now people are designing such type of quasi crystal for various applications such as a surgical instrument, LEDs light, non-stick five pens. Of course, it is also important to know particularly for students listening this, it is important to when you are in research or doing research, you have to believe, it is important point, you have to believe in what are you doing. Was such thing happened here, paper published by Banaras Hindu University students in 1978. Students, pentagons are seen in diffraction patterns in TAM, but unfortunately these students immediately gave up. This is because professor whom they are working did not believe him, believe them in so-called quasi-crystal. Same thing happened to Dan Shedman. Nobody believed him. And to that extent, his postdoc supervisor asked him to please leave the group, but he never gave up. And continuing his research in 2011, he got Nobel Prize. And this is the last example of advanced material here, gold. Glittering yellow color of gold attracts everybody, especially for females. This is possible only when the grain size of the gold beyond about 100 nanometers. The moment when the gold size or grain size of a gold become 50 nanometer, it becomes green in color. The moment when you bring it about 35 nanometer, it is red in color. And when you become change the grain size of the gold about 10 nanometer, it is actually a black in color. So optical properties of the gold significantly introduce or change at when size of the grain size of a gold is reduced. Now I can tell you a problem goes to Tanish researcher. Can you make 24 carat gold as strong as 20 or 22 carat gold? 24 carat gold without adding copper to it. So researcher reduced the grain size in grain refinement. They launched new benzes which are 24 carat gold, which are at the same strength which you achieve to 22 carat gold. This is because you are able to make them stronger without adding elements to it. Typically, with all you know, golds become stronger by alloying it. The moment you alloying it is impure. When you don't want to material become impure, the same material is strong. So lots of thing is possible. Just play with the materials at the small scale. This is something that changed the whole research. Now these are the references for this lectures. These are the publications